Hoot salute. Hoot hoot.
Percent recycled.
92.
That other 8%, who knows?
Over 90% of the building has some type of natural light. And you can see, like, even the corridor. This is one of the simplest buildings to get around in, because every single floor has a straight corridor like this, and it has a window at either end. So you're gonna get natural light, and you're gonna be able to find, there's a stairwell at each end of the elevator, or at each end of the corridor, and then there's an elevator, set of elevators on one end. So circulation through the building is real simple. Always through this one portal. Yeah. The whole idea is that so this cool. Is all e-waste that we collected from our campus, our university. So there's a couple cell phones. Look at all the cell phones over there. They say that your very cell cool. Phone made the wall. For lectures and events and stuff. Yeah. Oh, here, this is something cool, guys. All the water that comes down the roof drains is being collected for reuse to water like the roof garden and stuff. And so they put this pipe in here so that on a rainy day you can come here and check out and see,
that's cool.
See what's coming down the tubes. So these are public available lockers for people who commute or people who ride their bikes or you know, take an alternate mode of transportation. One of the typical class areas. And the sensor, there's a sensor right by that pole there. That one sensor is a light sensor. As the natural light comes in, it's going to start shutting down lights from the window side in. So on a really, really bright day, you probably use, you know, maybe just one row of lights, if any, depending on how much natural light comes in, and the lights just shut down automatically. And then these long things here you see are not conventional air conditioning vents. They're something called a chill beam. These things allow the air to be cooled right here in the room, so it saves a lot of energy and a lot of heat loss.
I'm working on the fiber right now. This is a fiber strain that runs all the way back to building 22.
Wow.
The main computer room. When they hook it up, the network comes over here.
See, the architect actually took the building and treated each side differently. On the north side of the building, we have no shade. South side, the sun is always a little bit further down, so you get a lot more heat gain. So what the architect did is created two things here. We have this light shelf, which you can see up above the light shelf, there aren't any panels, and the light actually comes in here and reflects off of this thing, bounces off the ceiling, and gets the light like deeper into the space. The screen that you see there was designed to reduce by about 60% the amount of heat that actually comes in and touches the glass. If you look at the glass is like a little over an inch thick on one of the balconies.
It is Mark's
office. No, Brenda.
That's Brenda,
this
right?
This is Brenda Kodos, is right here, yeah.
Kodos office?
The dean's is down here.
Oh, the office is here. Yeah,
this is the dean's office.
Right, but one of us is the
that's his secretary. This is the old floor from the basketball
from the court. Borough, before the hurricane.
Yeah, before the hurricane.
Really?
Awesome, man.
We salvaged all the floor before they redid it.
Talk about recycling. Rex Walters cooked on this floor. Rex Walters.
We're going to put the same Jersey logo. The same logo.
You know the dean's room.
This is the dean's conference room. If you look to the left there, you see a lot of the plants are in these little crates. Those little crates are actually designed as a system that, like, they put them in place like puzzle pieces, and that's how the roof will grow. The big pots will have big trees in them. The small stuff will be in those little crates like that. And this gets irrigated with the reclaimed water like we talked about.
One more.
Thank you.
What?